Hello everyone, Shea Burn 1000 here.
Monkey!
We got Monkey here. Tonight we're going to have spooky story time. And we're going to have a giveaway.
Yay!
And we're not going to tell you about the giveaway. We can't give it away tonight, but we're doing a giveaway. And I'll tell you what we got planned for Halloween. Mm-hmm. Stick around, it's going to be spooky.
Ooh.
Ooh. First, let's talk about the giveaway.
Okie dokie.
Okay. I'm going to be giving away these Dear Fammy heated gloves. I did a review on these not long ago. Very nice gloves. I don't need them a lot down here in Florida. There are times when you do need gloves. It does get cold enough. But I would rather, you know, share these with someone, so they are very nice gloves. Well, I don't have batteries in them, but they're grippy, and these are a large, I think. Yeah, they're large. So I thought I would share and do a giveaway of these gloves. Okay, so now this is how, if you want to try to win these gloves, this is how we're going to do this. It's going to be a little different this time, okay? So what I'm going to do tonight, like I said, spooky story time, right? I want to tell you guys two spooky stories. They're going to be scary. So scary, it'll make your head spin.
Yeah.
Yeah, like The Exorcist. Get it? There's playing words there. It'll knock your socks off, man. So, okay. But I want to tell you two scary stories. Or spooky, whatever. Anyway, one's going to be totally fabricated. I'm going to make it up right now, you know. Well, when we tell them. I'm going to make one up, and one's going to be a true story. And the first one, and you have until October 30th at midnight to do this, but the first person, no, you know what, we'll do a drawing, but we're not going to, I'll tell you why I'm not going to do it on camera here in just a second. I'll tell you what, if it's only one, the person, you have to guess which one is real, which one is the true, real story, all right?
Yeah.
And you're going to email that to me at BrunoBear5000, okay? That's at gmail.com. BRUNO5000@gmail.com. It'll be on the screen right now. So you'll email me your answers. Make sure it's before October 30th by midnight, because October 31st, I'll tell you why, we're going to be really busy. Now, so I won't be able to, you know,
do it that day.
But I'm going to tell you the winners on Halloween. On Halloween night. All Hallows Eve. October 31st. Now, providing there is more than one right answer, we're just going to put it in a fishbowl. We're going to put the names. Also, tell me the name you want said on camera, because I'm going to be announcing the winner. So whether it's a channel name or your real name, it doesn't matter to us. Just whatever. Make sure you give me that name. We'll put it in a fishbowl and we'll pick one, and that'll be that. Now, and I'll announce the winner Halloween night. Now, the reason why I'm not going to be able to show the drawing is because we're going to be live streaming. I know, I've done the drawing live stream before, right? Mm. But this time, it'll be kind of hard to do.
We won't be here.
And yeah, we'll get there in just a second. I have made reservations at the Lakeside Inn in Mount Dora, Florida.
Yes.
It's supposed to be the most haunted hotel in Florida or something.
Yep.
But it is the oldest continuously running hotel in the state of Florida.
Right.
1883, I think it was. That's what, 130 some years?
Mm-hmm.
So, we're going to stay there at the hotel. That's going to be awesome. Now, why can't I do the live stream in the room? Why can't I just, because I'm going to be live streaming, why can't I do it in the room and do the drawing, Mama?
Because we'll be busy, babe.
Yes, we're going to be walking down the street. Live streaming. And we're going to do that because I also made reservations and got tickets for a 2-hour haunted tour.
Yes.
Ghost tour. It's a walking tour.
Right.
Right. I'm going to live stream that whole tour.
Right.
So, I will announce the winner during that tour, during the live stream. Now, it might be right at the beginning, it might be somewhere in the middle, or it might be at the end. So you're going to have to watch the live stream and find out if you want. Okay, I will announce the winner. And I will give you 24 hours. All right, I'll give you 48 hours. Let's see, that'll be, I'll announce the winner, that'd be what, Thursday night. I'll announce the winner's Thursday night. You'll have until Saturday night at midnight, which would technically be Sunday. So Saturday night at midnight, which would be what, the 2nd, November 2nd,
mm-hmm.
You'll have to get a hold of me and to claim, you know, once I tell the winner. Follow me? Follow what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm.
Are you guys following me? Because she's already lost her.
No, you haven't lost me.
Once I announce the winner, you'll have until Saturday to get a hold of me through the same email that is on the screen right now, again, and to, you know, tell me, to give me your personal information and stuff.
So we can send it to you.
So, yeah, but I'll announce the winner, you know. But yes, you have to, you know, email me also which story is true. And I'll announce the winner on Halloween night.
Right.
During that live stream.
Yeah.
So watch the live stream. And then you get a hold of me within 2 days, you know, 48 hours, and give me your personal information so I can get these gloves sent out to you. Right?
Right.
All right, there you go. So I guess we need to tell a scary, spooky story, huh?
I guess you need to do that.
All right. But first, we must prepare.
And I don't know these stories.
So no, she don't
I
know.
I don't know one.
Even the real one, I have never told her.
So I won't know if it's real or not.
And the fake one, of course, she don't. I don't even know yet. I'm going to make it up as we go. But even the real one, she does not know. So she doesn't even know which one's
no.
real. So, all right, let's set the mood. Yeah, we're going to set the mood, and we're going to tell spooky stories. Mm. You guys ready? Are you excited about Halloween? Because we are, huh?
Yeah.
Bruno's coming, too. He gets to go, too.
Yeah, he's coming with us.
Yeah.
Of course.
And we're going
to... Part of the family.
We're going to do some... We'll probably do some filming, too, after that. And probably before, too.
Oh, yeah. We're going to go through that whole place.
Yeah.
I got my box coming with me. We're going to be into it, aren't we, babe?
Yeah, I guess so. Yeah, we're going to take our equipment with us and stuff, so... But that'll be in a separate video. But I thought for Halloween, because I was like, what are we going to do this year? We came up with this the other night, and then I thought, you know, I'm going to live stream that whole thing.
Yeah.
It's a two-hour walking tour.
Mm-hmm.
A ghost tour, they call it.
Right.
So we're, and it's going to start right at our hotel.
Yes.
They're going to start in the lobby of the hotel we're going to be staying in.
Yep. So that's going to be fun.
Yeah. So, and it's supposed to be one of the best tours, so.
Yeah.
Where they don't dress up and act stupid.
You know?
Apparently they just...
And a lot of this
they give all the facts. And
your outdoor is really haunted.
Yeah.
So we'll get a lot of real information.
Yeah, yeah.
We're not going to get fake. So.
Yeah, because sometimes, you know, those tours, they just guess it, you know. Well, this happened in either 1770, 1780,
yeah,
you know.
Right.
They don't know.
Right.
You know, I guess these are pretty much factual. Yeah. Stuff that we're going to tell and documented. They're going to be documented stories.
Right.
Not made up stories or, well, as I said, they're going to be documented. So that should be fun.
Yes.
Yeah. So we're going to set the mood and then it's story time. And just like that, we're back.
Mm-hmm.
In night vision. Because, you know, we want to be spooky. So, all right, you guys ready? Good. You ready?
Yeah.
Okay, so, story number one. Now remember, only one of these is going to be true. You have to tell me the true one. All right, so, one day in my hometown, I was talking to my neighbor one night, we'll just call her Helen, all right, and she said, you know, we was having a couple drinks and sitting outside on the deck, and she said, I want to ask you, how long you lived in this town? I said, well, I lived in this town all my life. She said, well, you know, I moved here about 5 years ago from out west, and she said, do you know anything about this neighborhood? I said, not this neighborhood particularly, you know. I don't know a lot of history about this area, but I said a lot of areas I do know a lot of history about, but right in here, as far as I know, it's just a neighborhood. Why? She said, I've been hearing some things and just weird stuff. She says, I know you're going to think I'm crazy. I'm like, no, I you know, I'm open-minded when it comes to this. I believe in that stuff, you know. And she said, well, okay, that's good, because I'm going to go ahead and tell you. And so she went on to tell me that one night, you all right?
Yeah.
One night that she was just sitting there reading and had the TV on, and well, she lived alone, you know, and but it was just a small house, and she said she could smell cigar smoke, and she said, well, she thought it was me, maybe, you know, because I smoke cigars, right? And she thought maybe it was me, and it was just coming in her windows, you know. And so she was like, I didn't think anything of it. And then she said later on that night, she said, I thought I heard somebody come up on my porch, because she had a little porch. She said, you know, I heard the two steps, and then it sounded like somebody walked over to the door, but the door never opened and no one ever knocked. I was like, well, you know, that's strange. So, but she said as soon as she heard that, she smelled cigar smoke again. So, I was like, wow, that is pretty weird. And she said, oh, I'm not done yet. I said, okay. And she said, so she said, now that happened several times, but, you know, I've kind of gotten used to it. Because if somebody comes to the door, like, you know, like if I would go over or something and, you know, somebody just always knocks, or, you know, her friends or whatever would just come in or whatnot. So she says, you know, now when I hear that, you know, and nothing happens, I smell that cigar smoke. She says, I'm kind of used to it, but it's still freaking me out. But she said, man, she said, the other night, When I was in my room, she said, I kept hearing a faint voice. And she said, I can't tell you what the voice was saying, but she said, I just kept hearing like someone was in the other room, you know, just talking real low. Mm-hmm. You know how that sounds, you know, like if you're in another room and somebody else out. She said, I kept hearing this voice, but it was only one voice. And she said, no, that really bothered me. And, but she, that's how I smoke her. Mm-hmm. But she said, and I was like, man, this, you know, this is getting strange. She said, oh, wait a minute. She said, no, last night, this is the weird thing, you know. She said, last night, she said, I just got out of the shower. And I come out, and she said, I was in the kitchen. And she said, I kept smelling burnt food. She said, I can't, you know, I haven't cooked in over a week there, you know, because she lived alone. She'd eat cold cuts and whatnot. And she said, I kept smelling burnt food just all night long. She said, all night long, I just kept smelling it up until this morning. It finally dissipated and went away. I was like, that's weird. I said, I don't know what. Because she said, you know, what do you think? I said, I don't know. I don't know what's going on. You know? And, but she said it just smelled like somebody was cooking and left something on in the frying pan too long, you know? Mm-hmm. And it just, like, burnt up like burnt bacon or something. Mm. I said, wow, that's weird. So, we talked for a little bit, but that kept bothering me. So, it was like the next day I called a couple friends of mine and older guys, you know, because it's going back several years, but these guys were older guys and they knew the town a lot better than me. So one guy I knew I could trust, I said, you know, I told him what was going on in the house right across the street from me, you know, that the woman, what was happening. And he said, well, it's probably, I'll just say George. I don't want to say any real names because, you know, just don't want to do that. Mm-hmm. So he says, well, it's probably George. Who the hell was George? And he said, he was a guy that lived there in the late 60s. I said, really? And he said, yeah. And he says, he was known to smoke cigars and pipes. And he said that he would go out in his front yard or whatever and do his little thing. And he had a chair that he would sit on right by the front door. And he would go up them two little steps, walk across the porch, and sit down in his chair. Mm-hmm. But he wouldn't go in for a while until it was like later on. So I'm thinking, wow, that's putting, you know, I'm putting two and two together here, thinking it's probably what she's hearing in the evening, mm-hmm. right? Because that's what he would do. So he wouldn't go in the house. He would go up on the porch and sit down in that chair for a while. But I said, I told him, I said, well, I asked him, I said, what happened to the man? Because I didn't get to I wasn't done with my story yet from what Helen had told me. I said, so what happened to him? Is he still around? Could I talk to him? And he was like, no, man, he died, you know. He died in the late 60s. And he said he lived in the house for like 20 or 30 years. He was an old man. I said, oh, he did? He said, yeah. He said, I said, well, how did he die? Did he die of a heart attack? And he said, no, smoke inhalation. So he had a cat, right? Well, he put some food on to cook supper and went outside to do, you know, his roses and shit and whatever he did in his front yard. And he went up on his porch when he got done and sat down in that chair. And then he started smelling his supper was burning. When he come in, you know, the kitchen, the stove was on fire, you know, the food was on fire. And he was trying to find his cat. He didn't know where his cat was. And by the time he got to the back bedroom, he couldn't find his cat. He was just choking so much because he was an old man and he just passed away because of smoke inhalation. But the neighbor had, because the neighbor heard him hollering and yelling for that cat, which was unusual, you know. So the neighbor came out and seen smoke coming out of the windows, you know, so called the fire department. And of course, the fire department came, put the fire out. And it was, you know, minimal damage to the house, but, you know, the kitchen was, you know, needed redone there. Well, pretty much the whole house, but because it was smoke and water damage, but it was, you know, fixed up after that. And so that's the story. So, and she was smelling, you know, burnt food. So there's story number one. What the hell was that? Oh, so last night, before we get to story number two, it was 3:20 a.m. I'm in there and I heard something really, it was loud, and I thought it kind of, from in the bedroom, kind of sounded like a, like Bruno. He get, when he sneezes really loud. Mm-hmm. And now, what the hell did he get? Because sometimes he'll be out here eating a snack or something. We'll go in the bedroom, close the door, and he gets trapped out here.
Right.
And so I was like, what the hell is that? So I came out, and as soon as I get up off the bed to open the door, I heard him come out from his tent. He's got a tent he sleeps in the bedroom. So it wasn't him. And I cannot figure out what that noise was. I looked all through the house. I woke her up to look through the house because we have that noise on security cameras.
Yeah.
Yeah. Of course, there's nothing moving in the security cameras because nothing's out of place till today. We don't know. But it sounds like when we hear it closer to the mic, you know, from the sound, we it kind of just sounds like somebody took a book or a magazine and threw it down onto the tiles here. We got ceramic tiles. And that's what it sounded like just one time. Psh!
That's weird.
Really loud. So I'll get that posted for you in the next day or so.
That's interesting.
Yeah, that was weird. And like I said, I came out and looked. I woke her up, told her, I said, come here, you got to listen to this.
Yeah.
And sure enough, yeah, it sounded like maybe someone, you know, remember the old phone books? Like, threw down the phone book. Or,
that's,
you know,
what it sounded
a
like.
Tablet or something.
Exactly.
You know?
Not like the phone books, tablet, the heavy tablet, phone tablet. Books.
Yeah, like an old phone book, you know, threw it down. That's what it sounds like. We can't figure it out. Nothing fell.
No.
Nothing fell on either one of the refrigerators. It was definitely in here. It wasn't back there.
Mm-mm.
It wasn't in the garage because there's a mic up there. It picked it up in this general vicinity here. So, all right, let's get on to story number two. All right?
Yep.
So, let me see. All right. I was probably between 13 and 15. All right? And me and my dad one night, it was on a weekend now. My sister just lived a few blocks from our house. And it was a Friday night, it was dark time, and Dad and I was out doing something, and my sister needed a ride to her friend's house. She didn't have a car at the time. She lived in a little tiny old trailer. It was called Broad Street, and we were supposed to go get her at a certain time, pick her up. So Dad's like, all right, let's go get her, let's pick her up and take her to her friend's. I was like, okay, cool. Because I had plans later that night anyway. But I said, yeah, I got time. I'll ride with you, you know. I'll ride with you guys. So we pull up and Dad blows a horn. And, you know, Sissy looks out the window and gives us, you know, I'll be out in a minute thing, you know. Dad's like, okay. And we're just sitting there listening to the radio and talking. And just at the same time, like, we just both kind of looked out the windshield like this. And there was a pattern of seven lights. They looked like stars, but they was like really, really close. They weren't way out. They were like really, really close. And they were kind of like moving a little bit. And we watched this probably maybe 10 seconds at the most, right?
Mm-hmm.
Maybe 10 seconds. And we were sitting there watching. I looked over at my dad and he was looking up too. And my dad don't believe in never believed in any of this shit. Ghosts, anything, Bigfoot, nothing, right? Especially UFOs. But we're looking, and then all at once, this thing kind of, like you said, it was a pattern, but it was seven lights because I counted them. You know, there was four and then three. And then just all at once, it came even closer to us. Like, I mean, just barely over the top of trees. I couldn't see, like a craft or anything. Mm-hmm. But I could see the lights and they were close, like I said. And then it dropped down and then just like a shooting star. Mm-hmm. That fast, just boom. Gone. Yeah, I'm not kidding you. Yeah, gone. Just boom, right? I looked at my dad and I said, "Dad, did you just see what I saw?" And he was like, "Yep, I sure did. And we'll never want to talk about it again." And, well, we never did. That's story number two. So, guys, which one is true? The first story or the second story? So, I don't know what to call them. Just story one or story two. Only one of them's true. You have to tell me which one's true. And again, here is the email that you're going to send your answer to. And so.
Now, do they have to be a subscriber?
Yes, you have to be a subscriber. Okay. Very good.
I wanted to make sure get out there.
Yeah, I mean, I want you to be a subscriber. I mean, if I'm going to give away $40-$50 gloves here, I mean, at least you can do a subscribe. Right. You know, yes. So I mean, these are some nice gloves.
Yes, they are very nice, very comfortable. I put them on too, and they fit me just fine.
I would like to keep them, but I would probably end up doing motor work and stuff with them and ruining them, and cutting logs and stuff, and I would ruin them.
They'll be great for like snowmobiling or something like that.
They would be good for that four wheeling and stuff.
I mean, Florida, how often will we even use them anyways?
Well, there's times you can use gloves down here.
Yeah,
but when I need them, I'm doing work. Right. So I would ruin them. I don't want to see that happen. And besides, I want to share some of the stuff with you guys,
Right.
So, all right, Monkey, hit that light.
Okie dokie.
Let me see if I can turn this off. Whew. Hell, this is even more scarier.
Yeah.
Whoop, what's that?
I have no idea what that is. This function is currently not available.
I'm trying to find the... There we go.
We are live.
What?
We came back from the...
So anyway, guys, so there you go. One more time. I'll flash that up on the screen for you. There's the email. And these Dear Famy gloves. Remember, story one or story two? Which one has proved to be true? But Halloween's going to be a lot of fun.
Yes, I'm so looking forward to it.
So the next day or so, I'll get the... Because every Halloween I do a spooky story time, and I try to do it different every time.
Right.
And usually Halloween time, though, I'll like make up a story and do something funny and weird. Something different every time, though. Mm-hmm. But this time, there is a made-up story. But there's also a true story.
Yep.
So you guys find out which one. Then I'll get that sound, that noise we heard uploaded. Maybe you guys can help us figure out what it is. We've never heard that noise before. Mm-mm. It's just weird. What do you hear? It's really weird. All right, Monk, anything you want to say?
Nope. I think it'll be fun.
Yeah. All right. So, Monkey went to her first oddities market.
Interesting.
What's some neat stuff there?
Yes, there was.
You saw a Burmese python in a dead one in a jar.
Yeah.
And we saw the real spiders.
Living ones.
Yeah, they were for sale.
Yeah.
Yeah, they were alive. They were babies, little tiny. Some of them was a little tiny.
Showing how pretty they're going to look when they grow up. Yeah. I'm like, what?
They were beautiful spiders, though. I don't know if you see it through the camera or not. Mm-hmm. I had my chest mount
on.
Yeah. So, but yeah, guys. So hopefully you'll enjoy that because we're looking forward to four more days.
Yep, I am.
So we'll leave here a little earlier. And so yeah, gonna be a lot of fun. So that's pretty cool how we got a known haunted hotel. I mean, it's known all over the United States as being haunted. We got a room at that haunted hotel on October 31st.
Yeah.
We got the ghost tour on October 31st.
We just booked this.
Last night. Yeah. Was it last night?
Yeah. I think it was last night. Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. We just booked this because, you know, we wouldn't have done this if my mom was here.
No, we couldn't leave her.
It's too far away.
Yeah.
So.
And she can't ride that far anymore.
Right. So.
Without getting sick. And so we wouldn't have been able to. But her mom's in rehab. She's doing well, by the way.
Yeah, she is.
So.
She's doing great.
We thought, well, let's. She said, why don't you check Mount Door, check the hotel Mount Door, which I did before, and the prices were outrageous.
Mm-hmm.
Like $244 or something. And I got, almost half off?
Yeah.
Discount.
Yeah.
So,
I can believe it.
Yeah, and just like the ghost tours, you know, they're booked Wednesday, they're booked Friday, they're not booked on that day. I figure maybe people want to take their kids Halloween in or something, you know, trick or treating.
Well, it's a Thursday.
Yeah, it's a Thursday, but it's still Halloween. A lot of people, they'll take work off for it. I know I would take work off for Christmas.
Right.
So, I mean, but still, you know, and besides, that's at nighttime.
Mm-hmm.
It's like 7 to 10 mm-hmm. or something like that.
That'll be fun.
So, yeah, we'll start the live stream about 7:15, 7:30-ish.
Mm-hmm.
But, you know, to get that that night, you know.
Yeah.
But you know, some people go to parties and whatnot, but that was we were meant to go.
I think so, yeah.
Yeah.
Because
mm-hmm. last year I looked in a few places for Halloween night and I couldn't get nowhere.
Yeah.
Everybody was booked and shit, so
mm-hmm.
yeah, all the ghost tours were booked and all the hotels were, any interesting hotels that is, were all booked up. This year, got the hotel and walking tour. And it started in our hotel.
Yeah, that's nice.
Yeah, so a lot of people's been to that and done videos on them, but on the place that we're going to. But we're going to do it too, so.
This is our first up in Mount Door.
Huh?
This is our first time doing this on Halloween up in Mount Door. We've been up there.
Yeah, we've been to Mount Door many times.
Yeah.
Love the place.
Yeah.
Yeah, but this is the first time we've ever stayed in Mount Door.
Yeah, we've never stayed there. We always come home. Yeah.
All right, guys, so hopefully we'll see you then.
Mm-hmm.
But I'll have more videos coming up soon, too, so.
Yep.
Yep.
Okay, all right, okay.
I think it's all I got, so.
That's it?
Yep, that's it. All right, let me get this video up. 7:51. I was boiling chicken. We're having a late supper because we brought home food from the thing.
Yeah.
And we got food.
Yeah. So we're eating late.
So yeah, we're eating late, so I'm gonna make supper. I'm gonna get this video up. And we'll see you in the next one. Stay spooky, everyone. Shea Bear, the myth, the man, the legend. Gone for now. Monk.
Sister, guys.
Don't forget to check her channel out. And we'll see you in the next one. Bye bye, guys, and take care.